In 2020, as the COVID-19 pandemic forced much of the world to shut down, supply chains faced unprecedented disruption. 93% of all auto production in the United States went offline. 69% of electronics companies experienced shipping delays. To make matters worse, the week-long blockage of the Suez Canal by the massive container ship Ever Given delayed 350 other ships carrying more than $50 billion worth of goods and supplies. Taken in total, the effect of these simultaneous disruptions has been considerable, with consequences that are expected to continue well into the third year of the pandemic. Building a robust global production and supply chain network, or GPSN, is challenging for three primary reasons. First, today's supply chains are very complex, involving many organizations that are dispersed around the world. Second, companies are rarely able to design their entire supply chain directly. As a result, they have limited authority in managing anything beyond their direct suppliers. What happens if something goes wrong with your supplier's supplier? And finally, unlike banks, which are legally obligated to run stress tests and issue stability reports, companies in other industries do not face the same kind of regulations. As a result, many companies are not actually aware of the instability of their supply chains. To model the effects of widespread global supply chain disruption, this study developed a series of network simulations drawn from the global auto industry. Three major manufacturers were considered: GM in the Americas, SAIC in Asia, and VW in Europe. Using historical data and current supplier information, 2,100 network simulations were generated and analyzed to test the effects of several types of disruption: social or political unrest, natural or man-made disaster, and global pandemic. In each of the simulated networks, geography was critical when evaluating the shock trajectory of these different forms of disruption. Social unrest and disaster spread the most easily to adjacent countries across land borders. Pandemics spread most easily by air travel. In each simulated network, a supplier was shut down when more than half of the countries where the supplier had facilities were affected by the spreading disruption. As anticipated, the simulations showed that highly globalized networks were better on average at withstanding both local and global disruption than the automakers' real networks. But contrary to expectations, another finding quickly emerged. Highly regionalized networks were also more robust, and sometimes substantially more. Minimizing geographic distance between supplier and buyer, and picking suppliers that are located close to one another, both contributed significantly to robustness. Managers aiming to reduce the average exposure of the global supply chain networks to geographic shocks should introduce more regional supplier focus when replacing existing suppliers. Such regionalization creates additional protection from disruptions that spread across geographic borders. To find out more, please read Supplier Selection Practices for Robust Global Supply Chain Networks, a Simulation of the Global Auto Industry, by Maxim, Sytch, and others in California Management Review, Volume 64, Issue 2.